Can you understand? Cleanliness, huh?
Is next to godliness.
Cleanliness is next to godliness. When God is there any problem? If God presence, huh? Isn't it? So if your consciousness is Krishna, then you are pure soul. You are willing, feeling, thinking are all of Krishna. Then you are pure soul, then Krishna is existing. There you can visualize. Then you have no problem. If your thing is just offset, little, material desire is combined, then that becomes troublesome. You will never get happiness. You never become happy. Isn't it? Then, when we are not happy, when the ghost gets inside. Have you seen anyone? Solingur. Solingur. They are taking the neem kapatha, neem leaves. They do something, this. No, no. Like that, everywhere is there. Even in Maharashtra also, I saw that one. There also, that is very, very dangerous in Maharashtra. Krishna, I went there. I went for this Bhaktivedanta hospital. There was some more time. So I just wanted to have fun with that. So I very much scared seeing all those things. So that's not good. Please, we are also like this one. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also told this one. If you are not Krishna conscious, we are like a ghost. You are chased by ghosts. They are all running. To get the appearances of Krishna without having knowledge of Krishna. They are chased by ghosts. Isn't it? So Srimad Bhagavatam is revealing the truth about ourselves. What is the truth about ourselves? Can anyone tell one by one?
We are the soul.
We are soul. We are not the body. Don't bother for the body. It means that one. But we are not bothering for the soul and we are bothering for the body. Just against that one. Next, what are the things he's telling? You are eternal. Soul means eternal. Okay.
Yes.
You are eternal, but still we are scared of
death.
Isn't it? Our next point? No, that is the quality of the soul.
We are part and parcel of Krishna.
We are part and parcel of Krishna. It means not only part, we are parcel also. Means
we
never get separated from Krishna. But we are thinking Krishna is not there. I am free from Krishna. I can do anything as I like. That's wrong. Karmana, Daivanetrena. Always Krishna is visualizing us, supervising us. Supervising, there is one sloka also in this one. Bhartha. Drushtanthanamanta. Anumanta, yes, correct. That's the one, supervising. Always Krishna is supervising. He got so many agents. We cannot escape from Krishna. Isn't it? So in that Krishna is the maintainer also. Krishna is Bhartha means maintainer. One who maintains is only the Bhartha. There are so many meanings we have to understand. So we are part and parcel of Krishna. We are soul, not the body. We are eternal servants of Krishna. According to our activities, we are facing the reactions. But if you surrender to Krishna, when we commit mistakes, when we are not Krishna conscious, that time we commit mistakes. We already told that if you are Krishna conscious, you never cheat anyone, you never get cheated by anyone. Isn't it? So you are suffering because you are not Krishna conscious. That's why we are suffering. Isn't it? So you have to develop. How we can develop the faith in Krishna? Just by?
Hearing.
Yeah. Hearing about Krishna. So many people were talking so many things. One Brahmana thread was cut. Brahmanas cannot live here. I told one thing. Have you understood Krishna? What is Krishna consciousness? Arjuna took all the credits in Kurukshetra war. Same Arjuna could not save Krishna's wives. Why? Krishna, one more point, Jayadratha. The killing of Jayadratha and escaping from its result, effects, is not possible for any human being. What is the thing? If he cut the head of Jayadratha, if false means?
His head will be broken into 100.
On whom it falls, the person will. But if that falls on the floor, he will become 1,000 pieces. It's possible for Arjuna to do that only. His father was meditating somewhere else. Only by the mercy of Krishna. Please understand, we are not the doers. We are the instruments. Those who got puffed up, they think that I am the doer, I am doing this. Arjuna was also puffed up, we can say like that one, but he could not, practically he could not do anything on his own. One more point. Arjuna never protested the killing of his beloved? Not son. Nephew, Abhimanyu, as though he knew before he's going to be killed. You are not recollecting the story? Abhimanyu was killed, no? But he knows, Krishna knows, but he never protested. If you can understand all these things, you never suspect Krishna. Finally, Krishna neglected to safeguard his own wives. Even dacoits, they robbed his own wives. Why Krishna allowed? The person he never understood, he never opened his mouth. He's talking about why the people, they cut the Brahmana thread. This Brahmanas cannot live in this world like this. I told, did you understand Krishna consciousness? Why Krishna did like that one? Why he neglected to protect his own wife? He cannot answer. And we are puffed up. We are telling, we are Brahmanas, we are going this and we are going. Any time Krishna conscious person never become perplexed. He never become unhappy. That person is there. Krishna conscious person. He could not answer for me that question. First try to understand Krishna. What is Krishna consciousness? Tattvata, how you learn Krishna. Then you don't find all these things. Already in Bhagavatam it is mentioned. The symptoms of Kali Yuga. You want to go against that one's scriptural injunctions? He could not answer. You understand my point? There are so many various symptoms of Kali Yuga mentioned in Bhagavatam. Can you rectify them? How you can escape?
Holy.
Chanting. If you become Krishna conscious, that's the point. If you become Krishna conscious, then there is no hurdles in a life. Can anyone stop the waves in the ocean? Can anyone stop the waves in the ocean? How we can escape then?
Standing in the shore.
No one can try to stop anything that is going to come upon. Not only they are cutting the Brahmana, they are going to cut your throat also someday. Be careful. But how you can escape? You cannot stop the waves. How you can escape? Just try to land swimming. A simple thing we do not know. Just try to land to tolerate. Krishna is telling na matra sparshastha kaunteya sitoshna sukha dukha daha. The boat are coming. It's not only, it's coming through the senses. You have to tolerate, to learn. Learn to tolerate them. The waves, we cannot stop it. But if you become a best swimmer, they love the waves. Isn't it? They do not want to come out from the waves. Like Kunti Maharani is telling Krishna, please give me all the problems. I am very, very happy to think of you. Very, very happy not to forget you. Please understand these waves. No one can try to stop these waves. But if you become a swimmer, we love the waves. They don't like small waves. If they come, the big one, the children are very, very happy. They also jump over. That's a Krishna conscious person. He never feels sad. He feels happy. Oh, Krishna can do like this one.